عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى، لك الحمد إذا رضيت، لك الحمد بعد الرضا. اللهم لك الحمد كله وإليك يرجع الأمر كله، علانيته وسره، لا يهزم جندك ولا يخلف وعدك، سبحانك وبحمدك. اللهم صل على نبينا محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. All praise is due to Allah alone. We praise Him, thank Him, seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead, and whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. Last night I heard the news that my close friend or my best friend, whom I knew for almost 20 years, passed away. He was in the age of 47. This brother or this close friend, subhanAllah, his death was sudden. I'll talk, inshallah, about him a little bit afterwards. But I would like to talk about death. And subhanAllah, the word death itself, the word death itself is sufficient. It is sufficient as a reminder. It is sufficient as an advice. It is sufficient as an admonition. It is sufficient for us to remember the reality of this life. It is sufficient for us to know the purpose of our existence. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to advise his companions to always remember death, saying profusely, always remember the destroyer of pleasure. The companions said, O Messenger of Allah, what is the destroyer of pleasure? He said, it is death. Because remembering death will make you lose hope in living longer, which causes the heedlessness. It will make you content with whatever Allah Ta'ala has given you in this life. It will make your heart inclined towards the hereafter and energetic in worshiping Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala just by remembering death. Just by knowing that one day you will leave this life, one day you will depart from this life and proceed to the hereafter without any notification. And that's why when one of the companions, one of the Ansar came to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he asked him, O Messenger of Allah, who is the wisest one? Who is the most wise person? And the answer was, is the one who remember death the most and prepares himself for death the most. He is the most wise person. Those are the most wise people. They gain the glory of this life as well as the honor of the hereafter. The ulama, when they defined death, they said that death has five terms. I will talk about a few of them. They said death is a discovering. Death is a discovering. Why? Because at the moment of death, you will discover the reality of this life. At the moment of death, you will acknowledge that this life worth nothing. At the moment of death, everything will be clear in your eyes. And that's why Allah Ta'ala in the Quran revealed what will happen for the person at the moment of death and how everything will be clear to him. How he will discover the reality of this life. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, لَقَدْ كُنْتَ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مِّنْ هَذَا. Indeed, you are in heedlessness of this. The angels, when they came to the person taking his soul, they would say to him, indeed, you were in heedlessness of this. لَقَدْ كُنْتَ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مِّنْ هَذَا فَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ. And now we have removed your covering. فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ. Now your sight is so sharp. You will know the reality of your existence. You will know the purpose of your life. And some ulama said that death can be defined as taken away, meaning that everything that you possess in this life will be taken away from you. You will be stripped off from anything that you possess in this life. And you yourself will be taken away from your family, from your children, from your friends, and you'll be thrown in that dark hole. The wise person is the one who prepares three things before other three things approach him. They said the wise person is the one who leaves this life before this life leaves him. And the wise person is the one who prepares his grave before he goes into it. And the wise person is the one who pleases his Lord before he meets him. Because we shall all of us meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We shall all stand before Allah the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala in the Quran said, إِن كُلُّ مَن فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا آتِ الرَّحْمَانِ عَبْدًا. Everyone in the heaven and on earth will stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a slave. Can anyone escape? No. لَقَدْ أَحْصَاهُمْ وَعَدَّهُمْ عَدَّا. Allah ta'ala has counted them with full counting. And He knows every one of them. He knows every one of us. وَكُلُّهُمْ آتِيهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدًا. And everyone will stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment alone, without any protector, without any helper, without any defender. No one will be there but you before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you will have your actions with you. You will have your deeds with you. So if you are a wise person, you will have to prepare yourself for that meeting. Brothers and sisters, I would like you to compare between this life and then the hereafter. Between this life and the hereafter. But before this, I would like you just to have a little idea about the hereafter, about our last abode, inshallah, Jannah. And before this, just imagine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enabled you to walk across the bridge over the hellfire, and now you are before the gates of Jannah. Imagine just that you have managed to walk across the bridge over the hellfire, and now you are before the gates of Jannah. If you look behind, you will see the hellfire blazing and flaming. Then you will say, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, who saved me from you. As Allah Ta'ala in the Quran described, وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ. At that place, we shall remove any hatred in their hearts against one another. تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارِ. The rivers are flowing beneath them. وقالوا الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا. And they will say, praise be to Allah alone who has guided us to this. وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. Without Allah's guidance, we would have never reached to here. It is Allah's guidance. It is Allah's direction, Allah's help, Allah's guidance through which we are enabled now to pass across the bridge over the hellfire, and now we are before the gates of Jannah. And then they will be called, come forward and enter Jannah. وَنُودُوا وَنُودُوا أَن تِلْكُمُ الْجَنَّةِ أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. They will be called, come forward, enter Jannah, which you have inherited for your good actions, for your good deeds. Imagine that you are before the gates of Jannah, and if you look forward, you will see the prophets, you will see the messengers, you will see the companions, and you will see the righteous people, and you will see Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam leading them all towards the gate of Jannah. And then he will knock the gate of Jannah. The keeper will say, who are you? He will say, Muhammad Ibn Abdullah, he will say, yes, I was only commanded to open for you and not to anyone before you. Then he will open the gates of Jannah. Imagine that you are there and you can see the bounties of Jannah. You can see the abode of the everlasting peace and happiness. You can see a wonderful sight, bounties the eyes have never seen, and ears have never heard, and hearts of human beings have never conceived. You see Jannah, which you were promised. And as soon as you enter Jannah, you will be greeted by the angel saying to you, beatitude upon you. Well done. Congratulations. Salamun alaykum tibtum. فَادْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا. Those who used to fear their Lord in this life, they will be taken to Jannah in groups. حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا. And once they arrive there and its gates are open for them, وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. The keepers will say to them, peace be upon you. Salamun alaykum tibtum fadkhuluha khalidin. Well done, enter Jannah and abide in Jannah forever. As soon as you enter Jannah, you will be able to know your palace in Jannah, your dwelling in Jannah, your abode in Jannah. You don't need anyone to show you your place in Jannah. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, by Allah, I swear by whom my sword in his hand, that the people of Jannah will be able to know their dwelling in Jannah more than them knowing their own dwelling in this life. And then he said, if you want, recite the verse on which Allah Ta'ala said, وَالَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فَلَنْ يُضِلَّ أَعْمَالَهُمْ. Those who sacrifice themselves for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will not cause their actions to go astray. سَيَهْدِيهِمْ وَيُصْلِحُ بَالَهُمْ. That Allah will guide them and give them peace of mind. وَيُدْخِلُهُمُ الْجَنَّةَ عَرَّفَهَا لَهُمْ. And he will let them enter Jannah, which he has made known to them. So you will know your dwelling in Jannah. You will know your palace in Jannah. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the first group to enter Jannah will be like the full moon at night. Their faces will be like the full moon at night, out of beauty and brightness. And the second group to enter Jannah, their faces will be like the most shining star in the heaven. Subhanallah. And in Jannah, they will not defecate, they will not urinate, they will not spit, they will not answer the call of nature, they will not blow their noses. The companions asked the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying, what about the food? What will happen to the food? He said, that food will be digested, producing a belch or a smell like that of misk, perfume. Allahu Akbar. Their sweat will become perfume. And they will be, subhanallah, they will be enabled to praise Allah, thank Allah, glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as easy as they breathe. The brothers and sisters, I won't talk about the highest rank of Jannah, I won't talk about the palaces of Jannah, I won't talk about the rivers in Jannah, I won't talk about the high ranks of Jannah, I will just talk about the lowest rank in Jannah, so that then we can compare it with this life. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, may Allah's peace and blessing be upon him, he said to us that the lowest person in Jannah will be given 1,000 servants. Each one of them will do for him a different task. And then he said, if you want, recite the verse on which Allah Ta'ala said, وَيَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ وِلْدَانٌ مُخَلَّدُونَ. And round about them, youth of everlasting brightness will serve. إِذَا رَأَيْتَهُمْ حَسِبْتَهُمْ لُؤْلُؤًا مَنْثُورًا. If you see them, you will think them scattered pearls out of brightness. وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ ثَمَّ رَأَيْتَ. And if you see again and reflect again, نعيما وملكا كبيرا. You will see a delight and a great dominion. This is the lowest rank of Jannah. The lowest person of Jannah is the one who will come out of the hellfire, is the last one who will come out of the hellfire crawling on his floor. And then Allah Ta'ala will say to him, go and enter Jannah. He will go to the Jannah and he will see people are residing there, enjoying their lives there. He will come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, oh Allah, I found it full of people. I don't have place there. Allah Ta'ala said, go back and enter Jannah. He will go there and he will think it's full. He will return back and say to Allah, oh Allah, I found it full. Allah will say, go and enter Jannah. He will go for a third time and return back and say to Allah, I found it full. Allah Ta'ala said to him, go and enter Jannah. And you will have like the entire world. You will have a kingship like the entire dunya. Nobody in the history of mankind managed to own the whole world. Go and enter Jannah and you will have a kingship like the entire world, like the entire dunya. And you will have its like, and its like, and 10 times its like, and you will have whatever your eyes desire and whatever your soul can be content with. This is the lowest rank of Jannah. Subhanallah. Compare the person who will acquire the lowest rank of Jannah with this worthless life. How long he will live in this life? How long? 70 years? If you are lucky, 80 years or 90 years or 100 years? At the end you will depart and leave this life. If you want to compare between this life and the hereafter, just do a very basic mathematical calculation. Very basic. Divide this life by the hereafter, you're going to have the ratio. You will know how much this life worth in the sight of the hereafter. Divide how many years you're going to live in this life by the hereafter. How many years? 100 years? 1,000 years? Any number of years divided by the hereafter. The hereafter, what it is? Infinity. Infinity. Any number that you divide by infinity in the science of mathematics, the answer is what? Zero. The answer is zero. So even in the science of maths, this life worth nothing compared to the hereafter. And that's why the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, if this life was to worth in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the value of the wing of the mosquito, Allah would have never given a sip of drink to any disbeliever. So this life worth, it's not worth your inclination towards it. It's not worth your attachment to it. It's not worth your neglection of the hereafter because of it. Allah ta'ala in the Quran said, كل نفس ذائقة الموت. Every soul shall taste death. وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة. And you will be given your reward on the day of judgment. That real reward will be given on the day of judgment. فمن زحزح عن النار وأدخل الجنة فقد فاز. And whoever is saved from the hellfire and entered Jannah, he is indeed a winner. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. Indeed, this life is nothing but it is a deceiving life. My friend Nasir, I knew him for almost 20 years. I met him before the Hajj. I was going to Mecca, met him before the Hajj. I said, just let's go and do Hajj together. He said, I'm thinking about it. It was one day before the Hajj. Then, subhanAllah ta'ala, I went to the Hajj by myself with my wife. And he called me while I was in the Hajj saying, Alhamdulillah, I have arrived to Arafah and I'm going to perform the Hajj, inshallah ta'ala. He came with his four sons. A little background of him. This brother, he's a professor of Tafsir. He dedicated his life for spreading the knowledge of the Sharia, of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He spent most of his time in studying the Quran and reflecting upon the Quran, pondering on the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he established a center that is called Tafsir. And maybe you have received some of his books, subhanAllah ta'ala. I met him in Mecca, I met him in Arafah, and I was wondering, he was subhanAllah ta'ala very engaged in making supplication, in invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in dedicating his time just for seeking forgiveness and repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking Allah the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even I don't remember that we had a time to discuss anything during the Hajj, although we have me and him a business together. And we said, okay, leave everything for now and we're going to meet after the Hajj to finish our business. He left and I had with him an appointment after a few days to meet somewhere else to look after our business. And subhanAllah, yesterday I heard the news that he passed away. So death can come at any time. Death can approach you at any time. Death will come to you without any appointment. But if you are a wise person, you will prepare yourself for that moment. You will prepare yourself for that incident. And that's why Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, حتى إذا جاء أحدهم الموت قال رب ارجعون. And once death approaches any one of them, he will say, oh Allah, let me go back and return back so I can do more good deeds. كلا ني إنها كلمة هو قائلها. It is a word that he gonna utter. It is a word that he will pronounce, he will utter. وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ بَرْزَقٌ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. But they have another life before they are resurrected. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bestow his mercy upon him. I'm very happy that he spent his life in serving the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Happy that he spent most of his life and dedicated most of his life in serving the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and supporting da'wah projects worldwide. And alhamdulillah ta'ala that I learned that four of his sons have memorized the whole Quran.